Mr. Jens Holm of Sweden, former member of the European Parliament, is another climate change expert. He has sent us his greeting and a message via video. Let's hear from him now.
My name is Jens Holm. I was a member of the European Parliament between 2006 and 2009. I'd like to greet all the participants of this very important climate conference. Here in Sweden and in Europe, we are getting prepared for the big climate summit in Copenhagen, Denmark. So it's very handy that you organize a conference about climate change, so you in the US also can get prepared for action for the climate. Because we all know that the situation is very, very crucial. It's not only a matter of putting pressure on the politicians. It's also a matter on what you and I can do. And I think there is a lot we can do. We all know about driving less car, stop flying with the airplanes, taking the train instead, and so on. But I think also we can change the climate by stop eating meat. The meat production is actually responsible for more than all the emissions together from the world's entire transport sector. That means that meat production emits more gases than the cars, than the trucks, than the airplanes and the boats together. So by stopping eating meat, you can save the planet and you can save the climate. So please, become a part of the solution. Stop eating meat. My vision is that by 2012, all countries in the world have adopted ambitious targets for cutting the emissions of climate gases, and that all of us were not any longer a part of the problem, we are part of the solution.
Thank you, Mr. Jens Holm. Mm-hmm. The effects of climate change are certainly being felt in the United States. In 2005, Hurricane Katrina smashed through New Orleans, leaving over 80% of the city flooded. Last year, Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger proclaimed a statewide drought in California, and temperatures are still on the rise. According to the U.S. National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, or NOAA, the combined global land and ocean surface temperature in September was the second warmest on record.
Climate change is having devastating effects on other nations. Our next address is from Mrs. Maneka Gandhi, the former Minister of Environment and Forest for India. She has been a member of the Indian Parliament continuously since 1989. Mrs. Gandhi has received many awards for her environmental work, including the prestigious ASG Jayakar Award for creating awareness about climate change, animal welfare, and deforestation. Please listen to Mrs. Maneka Gandhi.
I would like to say my namaskar to Supreme Master Ching Hai and to all of you in the audience. I wish I could have been with you today, but unfortunately I have Parliament. For many years now, we have been experiencing the problems of climate change. In my own constituency, there was a terrible drought this year. And just when the government had come to grips with it, it turned into an unseasonal flood. The farmers lost everything. The lentils I eat, regarded as a staple in India, are now so expensive that they have become a luxury. But we have no rain, no water, increasing heat, drying rivers, and dying people. Do you feel powerless as an individual to stop the world from dying? Let me explain how you and I can turn this around immediately. Methane and carbon dioxide are greenhouse gases, which means that their presence in the air traps heat and affects the Earth's temperature and climate, making the planet warmer. As it warms, the climate changes and the glaciers melt. When the glaciers melt, the rivers first flood and then dry up. Let's take methane. It's an easy problem to deal with. It's produced from four sources: livestock, livestock manure, rice farming, coal mine, and landfills. The time has come for both the developed and developing world to recognize that reducing methane is the quickest way to stop global warming while we wrestle with the problems of technology changes for reducing carbon dioxide. What makes methane so lethal? It may be less than carbon dioxide, but it is 23 times more efficient in trapping heat in the atmosphere than carbon dioxide. And methane has a large effect for a brief period. In fact, it lasts in the air for a net lifetime of about 8.4 years, whereas carbon dioxide has a small effect for a long period. What does that mean? It means that if we stop generating methane today, we will see the effect almost immediately. In developed countries, the eating of meat has risen from 65 kilos to 100 kilos per year. 100 kilos means over 300 animals are killed by one person every year. Meat eating, why is it a problem? Because it increases both carbon dioxide and methane. Producing one steak in your supermarket takes roughly 60,000 calories of energy. Keeping cattle or pigs, growing food for them, feeding them, transporting them, killing them, cleaning and packaging the meat, sending it by air-conditioned vehicles to the supermarkets, which keep it in freezers, then you buy it, then it's fridges at home, and then you cook it because you can't eat it raw. This is all carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide we increase because forests are cut by the minute in places like Brazil, China, Indonesia, India, so that we can graze the cattle, the pigs, the hens, the goats, the sheep. These forests absorb carbon dioxide. So when we cut down the forest, we cut down the carbon sinks and we exchange them for meat. Now come to methane and its relationship to meat. Livestock produce 23% of all methane because of the fermentation in their intestines, which produces gas in these animals. It produces it in their manure, in the wastewater that they produce. A single dairy cow produces between 550 to 700 liters of methane a day. The world's top destroyer of the atmosphere is not the car, nor the factory. It is the meat-eating human being. There is a 400-page United Nations report which has identified the world's rapidly growing herds of cattle as the greatest threat to the climate, forests, wildlife, and the continuation of the earth. Your ham sandwich is killing me. Your ham sandwich is killing the earth. Livestock produce more than 100 other polluting gases, including 2/3 of the world's emissions of ammonia. Ammonia creates acid rain. Acid rain destroys forests. And overgrazing has turned pastures and mountain ranges, like my Aravali range, which used to protect Delhi and no longer does, because it's become a desert. Cows soak up vast amounts of water. It takes a staggering 990 liters of water to produce 1 liter of milk. Wastes from feedlots and fertilizers used to grow their feed all washes down to the sea. It kills the coral reefs and it creates dead zones. There are over 200 dead zones in the ocean now, thousands of kilometers wide, including near India, including off Washington, which have no life. Diet change would make far more of a difference than trading in, for instance, your car. Many people think that if they trade in a standard car for a more efficient hybrid car, this will save the earth. But it doesn't. It reduces annual greenhouse emissions by just 1 ton a year. And then you create 1.5 tons by eating meat. All 1.5 billion cows in the world, you created them. They don't want to be killed, but you kill them to eat. In the process, you kill not just them, you kill the planet. Now, what can we do? The cost of reducing carbon dioxide are much larger because it needs technology. The cost of reducing methane is zero. Simply stop eating meat. You can remove methane in 1 day, starting with today's dinner. If you stop eating meat today, you will stop my Ganges Glacier from melting. And 23% of my people will survive because the magnificent and holy Ganges will stop turning into a stream. And how will this impact you? My people will not become refugees and storm your gates to enter your country. So not only will you save the world yourself, stopping eating will also stop so much poverty on the planet. It brings you better health. It eliminates most cancers. It frees up masses of land for vegetables and grains and really good eating. It allows water for the poor. For instance, do you know that one slaughterhouse in my city uses 16 million liters a day and one family gets 1 liter? Take the power into your own hands. You can become an earth saver. You don't need machines. You don't need governments. You don't even need treaties like the Copenhagen Treaty. You can stop it today by yourself. Maybe this is the ultimate lesson that nature is trying to teach us. Good gets good. Don't kill and don't be killed. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Gandhi. Your desire to protect all life is an inspiration to all. We wish you much success in your noble political service. Oh yes, and I want to tell the audience here that the complete unedited version of Mrs. Gandhi's address is on DVD in the gift bag you'll receive as you leave this event.
And now, for a dramatic change of pace. According to Time magazine, Albert Einstein was the quintessential genius of the 20th century. Often, when Einstein was faced with a problem, he would pick up his violin and play until a solution entered his consciousness. Music was the source of his inspiration.
Our next performer is definitely a source of inspiration. Ms. Ji Young Kim graduated from Yonsei University and has performed extensively in Korea. She plays the electric violin, often creating upbeat versions of classical compositions. This afternoon, she will share her lively rendition of Pachelbel's Canon in D Major. Please give a warm welcome to Ms. Ji Young Kim.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Ji-Yoon Kim, for uplifting our spirits and sharing your heartfelt enthusiasm for music.
Yes, that was truly inspiring.
I have attended many national and international conventions, workshops on topics ranging from conflict and peace to environment, ecology, indigenous peoples, human rights and so on. But I thought this was a unique experience for me. And I myself learned a lot from this.
I was getting stuff that was educating me and really hitting me hard, provoking my mind. I'm 57 years old and a few health issues. And what I've been hearing is, this could save my life. And they're talking about the climate, and it was just getting too overbearing, the vastness of the information, that I put my pad away and I just started listening. And I said, well, look, I hope they got a video or a website, I'll pick up on it. I'm calling it a spiritual awakening for the world, because I do want the universe to go on as it has been going on. It can't go on like it is right now, because everything is suffering. Now the climate affects everything. Today is a reawakening, because the tofu I enjoyed today, I thought it was steak, but it was so delicious. I have to learn the menu. It's a whole new language now. This is a whole new culture here. It's not about race. It's a whole new spirituality. And I'm just so privileged that God has put me in an environment that He has opened up my eyes to a wider horizon. And I'm just grateful.
My name is, hello, thank you for inviting me to the conference. I think this is a very important step towards a solution to the problem that we have for global warming, that is related also to the production of food in this country, in the United States, but mainly we are exporting also the problems that are associated with the production, mass production of what is called food, but I call it edible goods. And it is so close to the work that I do. I am the director of a Latino Center in Columbia, Missouri, and we help Latino families to navigate the health, education, and legal system of the state and the United States, because we receive calls from different states. So people ask me, and why it has to be vegan? Well, because for 30 years, the population of this country has been consuming those edible goods, mm-hmm. and nothing good is coming out from it. So it is a drastic situation. It is something that has to be changed in a very drastic way. So I want to be one of the tools out there that will help do that.
That's wonderful.
Well, thank you, and thank you, Master Ching-Hai, for bringing so much enthusiasm for thousands of people that they decide to do something that we decide to do something that is a little bit beyond our ego and beyond our satisfaction, because we are doing something good. My goal is to try to stop the madness of obesity and try to help people control their diabetes and their cardiovascular disease. I do research, I look for different physicians that are doing the same kind of work, and I enjoy very much SMTV because of all the information that we get there and the links mainly. You know, it's not just to listen to some videos of somebody talking about meditation and peace in the world, but the links, but the people that we can refer to, the contacts that we can make, scientists that are being interviewed. And that, for me, it's an eye-opener to the world.
All information concerning the scientific evidence of climate change and its solution is in Supreme Master Ching-Hai's book, From Crisis to Peace. Free for download at crisistopeace.org.
Kind viewers, we appreciate your presence today on Words of Wisdom.